arrival of Nalanda. In February 2006, the former Indian President Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam mooted the idea of revival of the ancient seat of learning, the Nalanda University. Since then, a partnership of Asian countries, apart from India, especially Singapore, China, Japan, and South Korea have played active roles in reviving the Nalanda University. Revival of Nalanda University under the aegis of Ministry of External Affairs was driven by the broader vision of establishing greater integration with the East Asian community. The vision, which forms a key component of India's Look East policy, has been articulated by the ministry.
The new Nalanda University campus is a 455-acre green sustainable campus situated in a predominantly agricultural area in the 2.5-kilometer outskirts of the Rajgir town. The land was gifted to the university by the Bihar government under leadership of Shri Nitish Kumar Ji, Honorable Chief Minister, Bihar. The campus comprises of over 200 buildings and structures having built-up area of over 20 lakh square feet, including development of 300 acres of landscape and horticulture works, construction of 12.5-kilometer internal road network, creation of around 100 acres of water bodies, including all modern services, utilities, interior and furnishing of the buildings.
The Nalanda University campus is probably the world's largest net-zero sustainable green campus. The key sustainability features for developing this net-zero campus include net-zero energy, net-zero water, net-zero waste and net-zero emission. This hybrid concept featuring renewable energy sources with the indigenous approach and its integration with various innovative technologies shall undoubtedly exemplify rational approaches to construction of other upcoming projects, campuses and community construction models in future. The campus combines state-of-the-art technologies with planning principles of the ancient Nalanda University to create a carbon-neutral and zero-waste campus. Some of the most important and indigenous aspects and palette of concepts for passive methods operating at different scales are 6.5 MW solar PV captive power plant, 1.2 MW biogas plant, desiccant evaporative technology for cooling, heating of the buildings, solar integrated thermal storage technology for HVAC system, use of compressed stabilized earth blocks instead of common burnt clay bricks, thick cavity walls to increase thermal resistance, climate appropriate landscape design to reduce potable water demand, decentralized water treatment systems, cooling as well as cleaning of the air through use of selected native plants, building management system, etc.
The main entry gate symbolizes the university as the temple of knowledge acquisition and a seat of higher learning. The first gate along the main road is the first threshold, marking the entry to the campus. The next grand entry gate, 7.5 meters wide, forms the neck, screening people and vehicles in. The large, curved volume creates a sense of pause and calm as felt in the temple entrances.
The academic spine is spanning in the north-south direction of the campus. It houses around 40 various capacity classrooms with a total capacity of 1890 students, varying from 25 to 300-seater classrooms, an examination center, international relations office, placement cell, meeting or discussion rooms of various sizes and other common facilities like faculty offices, laboratories, 100-seater mini auditorium, etc. In the southern side of the spine, the Grand Sushma Swaraj Auditorium is situated, followed by two guest houses, namely, Campus Inn and International Center. The academic spine is grand welcomed by a huge semicircular catenary.
The grand amphitheater, with a capacity of around 2,000 spectators, is situated amidst the center of the Kamal Sagar, the central water body. The amphitheater has a green room and a dais at its center. The structure is surrounded by the huge water body, which gives the audience sitting in the amphitheater an extravagant picturesque view featuring the lake in the backdrop. The amphitheater is surrounded by another circular 11 amenity modules, as seen in the aerial view, for informal discussions, small gatherings, chilling out space, etc. The administrative building is the backbone of the governance structure. This building with two wings is situated in the eastern part of the campus. The university administration, comprising of the Vice Chancellor's Secretariat, the administration and the finance, are housed in these two wings. In the northern side of the building, The huge 30 feet by 20 feet Indian tricolor mounted on a 108 feet tall flag mast multiplies the magnanimity and pride of the campus. The Ahas and Pines, as a part of the Net Zero Sustainable Campus Water Management System, adds to the exquisiteness of the aesthetics of the building. Like the rest of the campus, this building is also environment resilient and reduces carbon footprint, be it in the form of usage of construction material, methodology adopted, or the strategic energy including water consumption techniques.
The Nalanda Central Library Building is envisioned to provide state-of-the-art facilities for study and multidimensional development of intellect and a locus for collaboration. The building has a built-up area of 17,545 square meters. With more than 3 lakh books volume and over 3,000 user capacity, the huge Nalanda Library Building is being built in ground plus 5 floors. The building is shaped as a spherical stupa divided in 4 quadrants with an outer radius of 81 meters at base and height of the building at crown is 26 meters, which makes it probably the biggest dome in the world. The works for construction of this building is in full swing. In order to fast track the progress, precast construction methodology has been adopted wherein the structural member pieces of RCC pre-stressed columns, beams, walls and slabs are cast in the casting yard, transported at the site and erected sequentially floor by floor. Over 75% of the civil works for the building is completed and the building is likely to be handed over by end of this financial year. The Nalanda Yoga cum Meditation Center is being built right at the opposite to the Central Library Building. Built in ground plus one floor, the circular building has a built-up area of 4,186 square meters. The ground floor is a 500 capacity multipurpose hall, and the first floor is the yoga hall with 266 yoga mat capacity along with ancillary facilities like green rooms, clock rooms with lockers and toilet banks in adequate numbers in both the floors. For the VIP visitors, a VIP lounge facility is also there, which is connected with the yoga hall through a sky bridge. Roof of the building is spherical dome shaped. The yoga center building design symbolizes the 7 meditation chakras and entire planning of the base of the building including the surrounding landscape is based on Muladhara chakra. Roof of the building resembles the Sahasrara chakra. The VIP block has been designed and integrated with main yoga block to give a holistic retreat experience. Works of this building is also being carried out in precast system. Erection of both the floors of the building has been completed and overall physical progress of the building is over 80%.